So for today's video, we're going to be doing kind of like a what's the near energy, what's coming up for this connection, has anything changed, well, will anything change, that sort of thing. Instead of a pick a card, this is going to be a pick a number. So it's going to be 1 through 4. Obviously, whichever number pops into your head first, whichever number is more appeasing to you, go with that one. And I will post the timestamps in the description as well as the comments. If this resonates, please give a like, please subscribe, and I hope to see you guys in my future videos. I appreciate and love all of you, and enjoy
number
the video.
One, whatever. You guys get the point. So, what is going to be coming up in the near future for this connection? What are the energies? As well as, again, if there will be anything like, any movement, anything going on. Okay, well, we have scales. Keep your life in balance. So, keeping your life in balance. Hostilities. So there could be some hostilities maybe coming up for you guys. I don't know if this person who you have this connection with is defensive, like more on the defensive side, which would, you know, for a lot of you, it could make sense, especially if you're the feminine and they're the masculine. And especially if, like, you know, there's some disagreements going on. And again, with the like defensiveness. All right. For our love bomb, we have the people you love are very lucky to have you. That's what they would like to say to you. So let's get into these cards. Oh, wow. We have some interesting cards here. Okay. So we have some, like, some, I feel, okay, this is kind of like, saying, like, to go with your intuition. Some, because I feel you guys are going after something your intuition is telling you about this person. And it's funny because with the near energies, with the connection, we do have the Ace of Swords and the Lovers. So the near energy for this connection, it does seem as though there might be some communication. So if you're not in communication with this person, then basically this is saying, like, to trust your intuition that there will be, and to trust, like, your guides as well, like, that there will be communication about this. And then if you are talking to this person, and you feel like, say if you're with them, you're in a relationship and you have a sneaking suspicion about something, basically it's saying it's best to talk about it and put it on the table. Like, if you think they're cheating or whatever, to kind of just be like, tell me what's up, that sort of thing. Or maybe it'll come out, who knows. But again, if you're not in contact with them, it's about communication for sure. So I'm going to pull one more card. Let's see, how are they going to feel for you? So we have the Ten of Wands for how they feel about you. So what this is telling me is, it's like they feel as though obviously they've come a long way with you. They feel as though maybe they've done everything they can, like they've exhausted all their options, and it's like they feel as though, you know, a lot of weight is on them right now. As well as, yeah, like just feeling like some kind of ending for those of you in with this person, like they're feeling like it's coming to an end. And again, for those of you not in contact with them, it's just saying they feel as though they've come a long way with you. And again, there could be that communication about the connection, the, you know, the loving connection, especially with the Lovers card. So it's going to actually be about, like, where are we going with this? Like, I love, like, that sort of thing, you know, like, just spilling it all out, and getting it all out. Yeah. Because the Ten of Wands is that energy where it's, like, it's about carrying a lot, like, having a lot of weight on your shoulders. Maybe they feel as though that's occurred. They also could just have a lot on their shoulders as well. Like, maybe they work a lot. Maybe they're just always busy. They could put a lot of that weight on themselves. So maybe it's due to them. Like, it could have nothing to do with you. It just could be because they're the ones that carry, like, all of those burdens. Yeah. So, yeah, that was pile one, guys. Those are, like, the near future energies for the love connection. So, hopefully you paid attention to the if you're with them or if you're not, because that kind of makes a big difference. Okay? So, I hope this resonated. Give a like, subscribe. I'll see you guys in my next video. Right into this. So, what are the near future energies with this connection? Basically, what's most likely going to happen at this point? Is anything going to happen? Yeah. I admire your courage. Ooh. Work, achievement, and success. Good for you guys. That's a message for you guys specifically. Oh, I love this. So the near future energy for you guys specifically is happy family. So if you're with this person, this is going to be like, again, happiness between you guys, and especially if you have like children together, just like enjoying each other's company and spending time with each other. And if you're not with them, either way, this is the near future energy for like you guys. You're going to be like achieving a lot. You're going to be very successful, but as well as there's going to be happiness, there's going to be happiness and contentment in the family life and the home life, which is really important and obviously awesome. And overall, as this is also kind of like a mutual energy for the both of you, maybe you both feel as though you would be happy together. Maybe you both kind of have that mutual feeling like you would be happy together, and you both could like have a family, like that sort of thing, you know. So we're gonna get into these tarot cards. We have the King of Cups. This could either be Pisces, Scorpio, Cancer. I don't always like to go off a sign. Sometimes I do, because sometimes obviously with other people it'll be like it'll resonate more, you know. So sometimes it's cool to like just let that be known. However, this tells me that in the near future, the masculine is going to be in the feels. Like, it seems like the masculine is going to be very in the feels in the near future, and basically having deep feelings and kind of being a little emotional about it. Definitely, like, having his emotions also take part in the daily life. We have you, so if you're the man. The near future energy for this connection for the female is she's going to be very passionate, you know, sexy, successful, and this is going to be, you know, the near energy. I feel it's kind of showing me the individual energies between the male and female. Like, I feel the male's going to be, like, more in his emotions, and the female's going to be more passionate and more enthusiastic about life and kind of, like, you know, doing what she does, basically. It seems like there will be, like, the near future, there could be, like, a time where you get together with them and have drinks or go out with this person in the near future. But for others, this just could be, like, it's more like emotions in a third party situation too. This is, yeah, because even though the Three of Cups is about fun, about enjoying and friends. It also can talk about three being a third party situation, but emotions being involved essentially with the Three of Cups. Let's see. How do they currently feel about you? They feel as though we have the Five of Swords, so I feel as though they feel like they lost a battle between you two. Like, how do I want to say this? Like, it's like they thought that they were going to come out of this and like be happy that they did whatever to you, or again, if it had to do with a fight or a disagreement, he or she thought they were going to come out feeling like, you know, they're right. But I feel as though this is what I'm getting, that they kind of feel like they're not right, like it wasn't worth it. I don't know, that's kind of what I get. Let me see, get one more card. King of Swords. So Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, but this tells me as feelings, wanting to, I always get like the strong feeling, especially with the King of Swords as feelings, like wanting to really communicate, but it's like at a level, yeah, they feel as though, okay, so many swords. Oh, let me tell you. They feel as though, we'll put it this way. They, when it comes to feelings, feel as though they blew it. We'll put it that way. That's how I feel that they feel. They just think there was an ending. Again, if you did something to them, what have you, but for most of them, again, it's more like, you know, they won the battle, but did they? Did they, though? Did they win? I don't think so. So yeah, that was pile two though, guys. I hope you enjoyed that. Give a like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next energies video. Regarding this connection. I get butterflies in my stomach when I know I'll see you soon. Aww. That's mad cute. Guys, that's so cute. I always look forward to seeing you. What? They really like seeing you. Ooh. Situations in the balance that require careful handling. So there are situations that you guys are going through right now, especially it could be with this connection, that do require careful handling about like kind of like maybe making moves, that sort of thing. Just wanna see something real quick. Okay. What I do wanna say is, what do we have? Okay, so for the energy, we have seventh chakra, Archangel Uriel. So this is literally telling me like, this is definitely a spiritual connection. It definitely is. It's the seventh chakra, so it's spiritual, it's transformative, it's definitely a connection that's important, basically. We'll put it that way. And that's also like the energy. Okay, we have the Knight of Wands here, so Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. Then we have the Six of Cups reversed with the Page of Swords also reversed. I feel as though this connection, for most of you, you're not with them, because this is something that, like, again, it's a past card, but it's something that's, like, negatively, I feel, affecting you guys, and that's also the near future energy. It's like, it's in the past, but again, with the Page of Swords reversed, it's kind of like something needs to be communicated, or something needed to be communicated. And then with the Knight of Wands, you know, it talks about passion as well, in the connection. So trying, let me see, I'm gonna get a couple more cards, but trying to kind of maybe just dwelling on the memories, like for both of you though, it's kind of like just dwelling on the past, how there's been no communication. But with the Knight of Wands, actually, that could tell me there might be some movement. Like, let me see, how do they feel about you? Very. They're conflicted. It's like, okay, so we have the Knight of Pentacles, so that's also, that could be a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. But we have the Moon as well, so I feel they have fears. They definitely have fears when it comes to this connection. And with the Knight of Pentacles, again, I don't see any movement, because only because with the Knight of Pentacles, it's like slow movement. And you guys, and most of you guys know this. It's like wanting to come forward and either deliver a message, deliver an opportunity, but being fearful and worried about the unknown, probably like what's going to happen, as well as the Moon talks about like insecurities and the unknown. So that's how I feel the near future energy is going to be. I think that's why the Page of Swords is reversed. However, I feel you are on their mind though, because it's like with the Knight of Wands, it was so random. It's like, I know it represents a person, but at the same time, in a big way to me, it represents action. So to me, how I'm going to take that is, they are like, I feel you are on their mind. They are very passionate about you, definitely. I feel they are very attracted to you as well with the Knight of Wands. But yeah, this person, like, again, with the slowness, again, with the Moon, it's very clear that it has to do with fears. So yeah. But yeah, guys, I mean, it is a spiritual connection though. Like a deep one. Like you guys are, I feel, could be very in sync. But yeah, guys, so that was pile 3. I hope that resonated. If it did, give a like, subscribe, and I will see you guys next time. For this connection, what are the near future energies? Is anything going to change? What's going on? I admire your confidence. So this is something that they would tell you. This person thinks that you have confidence. Ooh, position of authority. Ooh, maybe. Okay, so those of you who chose 4, you could have like some confidence thing going on. Even if it's like fake it till you make it confidence, it's confidence. They like that about you. Ooh, for the energy. I'm like, ooh. Guys, the near future energy is indecision. Oh my god, like, so again, it'll be kind of like, I feel like the near future energy, but this is like, don't let this fool you, because this is a very significant card. This has so much to do with life, because this is about making an important decision. This is a decision of the heart. This is a matter of the heart. This is love. Basically, the near future is indecision, and it's the mutual energy. Okay. We have 8 of Wands. We have Death. We have King of Pentacles, and we have Seven of Cups. So, King of Pentacles, this could be your person. So, this could be a male earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. So, what this near future is telling me, especially with the male specifically, the masculine energy, they're going to be definitely going through, if they're not already, they're going through like a transformation. It could have a lot to do with their way of thinking as well. With the Eight of Wands, it talks about action, and I feel as though, and here's where the indecision comes in with the Seven of Cups. It's him wanting to take action, because, you know, wanting to transform and kind of like I don't know how to say, like, transform the relationship, but like make it so there could be a new beginning. But there's a lot of indecision going on. However, again, just like pile two, I feel that you guys are at the forefront of their mind. Something's coming quick for them that's going to transform them, but there's so much indecision going on. Let me see if I can get how I feel. Okay, so there you go. Oh, yeah. I don't know why I just said, oh, yeah. It's because I was going to be like, oh, yeah. Because I kind of got what was going on here. Okay. Guys. So, okay. For the near future energy, I'm not going to lie. It doesn't look like anything's really going to change. Like I said, there's that indecision. But there is something going on with them that's really going to change. They're going through some sort. It could be like personal transformation. But guys, we have the World card reverse and we have the Chariot reverse. So, no, I feel as though no one's coming forward in the near future. This person thinks that, you know, this has ended, basically. Especially with the World being reversed. They feel as though it's ended, you know? And the Chariot, again, no movement, not moving forward. But there's still that indecision, which is even bugging me. Okay, I didn't even do this. But like even this pile you guys chose is bugging me, because it's like, yeah, again, no movement, just stillness. And it's because of that indecision. Jeez. All right. Let me see. Give you guys advice regarding it. All right. It's funny because I just saw this card before it popped out. And I, for some reason, when I saw it, like, real quick, I was like, this is significant. And look, it came out. Basically, don't wait around for this person with the Four of Cups. Don't wait until, like, they offer you their love, their cup of love. I feel like it's a way of saying, like, they're not worth it. Like, not worth the wait, basically. Like, you know, to just kind of get back out there and not worry about, you know, when they're gonna offer this or what's gonna happen, because again, it's kind of like, especially during this time, it's like, you know. So basically just saying, not saying to give up, it's not saying like give up, again, there's just indecision going on right now, it's not saying to give up, it's just saying like don't focus too much on it, you know, try to focus on something else. I feel, you know, this could obviously become negative as well. So just try to kind of like get away from that. And again, your advice is to kind of like get out there and not worry too much about that right now. Okay, guys. So that was pile four. If that resonated, give a like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.
So for today's video, we're going to be doing kind of like a, what's the near energy? What's coming up for this connection? Has anything changed? Will anything change? That sort of thing. Instead of a pick a card, this is going to be a pick a number. So it's going to be 1 through 4. Obviously, whichever number pops into your head first, whichever number is more appeasing to you, go with that one. And I will post the timestamps in the description as well as the comments. If this resonates, please give a like, please subscribe, and I hope to see you guys in my future videos. I appreciate and love all of you, and enjoy the video.